Can you imagine a life without chips?
Chips are embedded in systems which are very personal to us. They are part of who you are.
We all feel the consequences of the fact that chips are everywhere.
Chips are indeed enabling functions that are getting closer and closer, literally, to our body.
Might go on your body and it is already going into your body. It will be very hard to distinguish the boundary between what is technology and what is you. Technology can do a lot. It has the promise of making quality of life better. The easiest way to characterize quality of life is probably when it is negative. What is very close to my heart is tinnitus. It is a brain disorder. It can be the result of an acoustic trauma by too loud music. And especially musicians, they suffer from tinnitus. Which ruins their hobby or their profession, but also can ruin their life. My mission is to push back that quality of life back to 100% as well as we can. And for me, it's really fascinating that it can be done with electricity. I used to see the body as a kind of a biological system, but we are amazingly electric. A lot of the signaling that's going on in our body is electric. We can tap into it. The chip can be connected via what we call electrodes to the brain. These people here will benefit from the technology that we develop.
Microelectronics is one of the most advanced technologies the humankind has developed. Can it also enable things you don't want? Are there ways of misusing it?
The data from your body, that can be very vulnerable.
When you need it, it's really good when it's there. If you're perfectly healthy, I think you should be not super enthusiastic to put yourself full of chips.
Broadly speaking, for systems with intelligence, we share such intimate information about us that in a way we do trust them with our lives.
My passion is about understanding what is inside us. We are creating houses for cells that in a nutshell recreate a human environment for tissues and organs outside the human body. Here we are testing an organ-on-chip device. It takes more than 150 steps to fabricate. If anything goes wrong, then we have to start again. At the center, it contains electrodes where we can measure the charges that is present in the medium of the cells. This device allows us to record the behavior of tissues and to track their electrical activity. We combine knowledge and deep understanding of tissues, organs, and human physiology with technology coming from the science of materials and of electronics. We are now living at the moment where this symbiosis is possible.
And if you cross domains, so like electronics body, then you are half in the dark, which is a real challenge.
It's a matter of acceptance. If it improves the quality of your life, then why not?
I would like to use technology to make us more human, and especially when it comes to healthcare.
Scientists are now able to create synthetically organs that capture deeply the foundations of our physiology, and along the way, better develop drugs, even at a level where they can become personalized. We are in the Science Biopark of Leiden, where a lot of developments are taking place and where also our collaborators from the LUMC are present. And now we have the perfect devices that are in a way familiar to the practitioners, to the biologists in this case.
I'm interested to record the electrical signals from these mini brains.
With this chip, we are able to connect to this activity and record it electrically. We also work a lot on heart. And heart is obviously a very different organ than the brain. They are actually very well connected in the body. And also similarly, they both produce electricity. We hope to use this technology to solve unsolved questions and development of new drugs. To really finally develop a better understanding of the human organism as a whole.
The more we know about the brain, the more possibility we see to improve the hampered performance of the brain and create better quality of life. So the more we understand of what good quality of life is, the more there is the need to contribute to that. And it's great that it can be done by means of microelectronics.
We also have to learn how to deal with technology and keep trying to figure out how to push boundaries.
The reason those things are getting more and more popular is they're showing more efficiency and productivity in our lives.
The technology we are talking about can help humanity move forward. And the mission is always for the greater benefit of humanity.
I don't think that technology itself is a good or bad thing. It is how we turn it into its effect.
I don't have a crystal ball, but it starts with understanding.
We strive to bring good solutions for today and for the future.
I think that's our responsibility, is to be ready.